What I have here is a document in regards to our cyber school technology solution for any information in regards to our software, that is digital science and virtual lab. The simplest way of having or helping a student learn science subjects. We have hundreds of teachers across the country acquiring the software, which is digital science and virtual lab. Of course, many thanks to the schools that have already managed to acquire the software itself. Green Hill Academy in there, Seroma Christian High School in Mukono. We also have Aga Khan High School, including Burenga Light Vocational School, and of course, New Horizon Secondary School in Mukono. It doesn't matter which part of the country, for as long as you're interested in the software, accessible via our main offices, that is in Lugogo Uma Showgrounds, that is in Cyber School Technology Solutions. Many thanks for the feedback on our Facebook and Twitter handle, that is CSTSUG, or our email address, that is info@cyberschooltech.co.ug.
Hello viewers, how are you? Fine? I believe you are fine. You are welcome to Light Secondary and Vocational School, Burenga. I'm Bazira Kizito, a teacher of physics, and I'm going to take you through physics using a software called Cyber, using digital science. I hope you enjoy. You are welcome. Now, I would wish, as per now, to first switch on your monitor, then the system unit, and you go to the interface where there is a cyber, student, and admin at that point. Are we at that interface? Very fast, let's make that. Digital science and virtual
lab.
Okay, good afternoon, class. How are you? Okay. Now, as previously, we looked at light. I believe we had looked at light. From light, whereby we looked at when we came to light, we had to look at some things. The first thing we had to look at what we call a what? A ray. Not so? And how did we define a ray? Someone to help us and define for us a ray. Yes, Oscar.
A ray is a path taken by light.
A ray is a path taken by light. And when we talk of a path, it means we are looking at the direction. And when we talk of the direction, we have to represent the direction with any arrow. So when I talk of a ray, it means I'll be talking of the path. But that path, I must direct it and give it a direction. Then that one, we shall have to look at a ray as the path, the direction taken by light. Then we come to a broad thing where we looked at a beam. I think we looked at a beam, not so? And what is a beam? What's a beam? Yes, Maimuna. Collection of light rays, not so?
Yes.
I think we looked at the collection of light rays and we looked at different types of beams, not so? How many types do we know? By show of hands, how many types? Yes, Lugos.
Three types.
The first one, yes, we have a parallel beam, Leticia, a divergent beam, then we have a convergent beam. So we have those three. We have the parallel. Then we have the convergent. And we have the what?
Divergent.
The divergent. Can we explain those three? Can we explain those three? Yes, I believe we can explain. But let's try to check from our digital science. What does digital science tell the cyber? Let's go and we log in. Let's log in from our computers. Let's log in. And the subject is what? What's the type? Which subject is it?
Physics.
It is physics. We go to physics. Then we are looking at waves. Have we clicked on waves? Then we select behavior of light. We are looking at the behavior of light. Then we go to show. Have we come to that point? Then at that point, What I've talked of, the number one and number two, it's there. As the objectives we want to look at. The first objective is defining a ray, and we have defined, but we shall need to see how is it. Then we come to describing a beam of light, drawing the diagrams for a beam of light, convergent, divergent, and parallel. Let's go to explanations, and let's try to see. Let's try to visualize it.
Light is a form of energy that produces the sensation of sight.
Light is the form of energy that produces the sensation of sight. Now, initially, when you try to look at that, it was dark. It was dark. After being dark, what happened? After a given period of time, there is some lightness which came. And when lightness came, we are now able to view what is here. And I think when you can try to check from your computers, let's try to check from our computers. Are we at the same point?
Yes.
When you try to check from our computers, we are trying to see that light is a form of energy that produces the sensation of sight. Now, from there we can go to the next one. When you go to the next one, then we are going to be looking at our bodies. The types of bodies we looked at, the luminous and nani? And we said luminous bodies, they give out light. An example, for example, by show of hands. Yes, Barbara? The sun. Then which other body which gives out light? Yes? The stars. The sun and the stars. But at first, this is what we must know. As you are seeing that is our star. The star is the primary source. The star is the primary
source.
But on Earth, it is the sun which is nearer to us. That's why we shall be looking. We are seeing the sun. Let's go to the next one and we shall see. We shall visualize. When we visualize, I think we have seen. We are seeing that is the what? The sun. Let's read up all together and we see. What's there?
The sun is our nearest star.
Yes.
It is a natural source from which we get most of our light.
The sun is the one which is nearest to us. On Earth, when we are here on Earth, we are trying to see that we may, even up to this point, you can say now the sun sets from east, rises from east and sets to? Is it true? How is it? Someone tell us, how is it? Those people who come from east, have you ever seen the sun? Is it true? Have you ever seen the sun? Okay. Now, what is nearer to us is what we call the what?
The
sun. That's why we shall, but the primary source is the what? Is the star. Now, when we come, after knowing this, it helps us to know the types of beams, the beams we have talked of. The first one, we talked of a parallel what?
Beam.
The second one, we talked of a convergent
beam.
Then the third one, we talked of what?
Divergent.
The divergent. Before we visualize, someone to explain to me a parallel beam. What is a parallel beam? Someone to define for me a parallel beam. You can go and draw it for us there on the board. Is that correct?
Yes.
Let's clap for Leticia. Someone to draw for us a convergent beam. Let's have a boy this time. Let's have a boy. A convergent beam. A convergent beam, is it correct?
Yes.
Let's try to clap for him. Lastly, I need someone to draw for us a diverging beam. Diverging. Yes, Simbazira. Come. Is it correct? Now, let's clap for Mbazira. Let's try to check from our cyber to the next point. Let's go to the next. Now they have defined for us a ray. Let's all read the definition.
An array of light is defined as the direction of the path in which light is traveling. It is represented by a straight line with an arrow on it. A bundle of rays constitutes a beam.
Very correct. That's what we had defined here. We said a ray of light is just a path, direction of light. And we have said it's just we represent it with a straight line when serving an arrow. And we said later that when we have a collection of light rays, what do we have there? Let's read what we are seeing on our screens.
A parallel beam of light travels in a straight line independent of each other.
Yes. Uh-huh. Now we are seeing a pyro beam. We are having how many light rays are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now when we combine them, those 5 rays, we call them what? A beam of light. But they are moving in a straight line and they are independent of each other. The spacing from the other one does not reduce. If it reduces, what does it mean? They will meet. But when they are parallel, they are not supposed to do what? To meet. Then let's click next down here and we look at another beam. Which type of beam is that?
Convergent.
Let's read and we see.
A convergent beam of light travels through a short distance and converges at a point.
Yes.
The distance between each ray starts with reducing from the beam.
Are you together?
I'm by name of Ntale Jonathan. I'm in Senior 2A. I study here at Light Second and Vocational School, Vulenga. I have learned things in this world through science, which is digital. This is no longer the analog ways where we used to suffer. We used to do a lot of work, but without help. We actually get things through viewing. Like when you're watching a movie, you can easily get a movie in your brain than when a teacher is writing on a blackboard. Some of us we see like it's a wastage of time. But actually science has helped us much.